around. The Tartan does go down, but he's going to be near the picks up the killer watch. Kevin goes very aggressive in there. How they got the damage? They can't seem to get on the position. They have not really got the vision or the positioning to get this fight going, and it's Mackler that picks up the double kill.
So they try 2 for 2, and Charu, another fantastic charm in that engagement, allows him to secure yet another exit kill as the fight plays out. Candy Panda with a very, very good cleanse. He actually counteracted that secondary pull of Thresh, and then when Thresh followed in, he pulled Thresh into the middle of his entire team. The problem was, the box then surrounded every single member of SK, and they were trapped inside the box, allowing all of the, you know, the splash damage from Ryze and from Ahri to stack up.
Charu is not done yet. He's still hanging around there. There is that ward from SK in there, though, so they have got vision of him. They're not going to walk so blindly in, but Charu really wants to get back on Candy Panda again.
Yeah, and he can. I mean, his Deathfire Grasp is going to be available, actually is available. He does have his ultimate up as well with that blue buff, and he's just going, well, look, I'm going to throw out a charm. If I get caught, I have three, you know, I have a hop, skip, and a jump from my ultimate to get to safety, and he can afford to play with fire effectively.
So 9-4 currently, Meteor Makers. Not gone 100% their way, but definitely is looking like they are in strong driving seat right now. 5,000 gold difference. You do see Meteor Makers clearing out around that Baron Ward and actually thinking of going for this one.
So they've started this one off because they realize they have vision control. They're going to see Hercubot sneaking up, and they may decide to actually pick a fight with Hercubot. We'll see how this pans out. You know, I think smartly MYM decides to back away a little bit. Some split decision making, but they're basically saying we're not 100% convinced about this engagement. The rest of SK are slowly starting to group up, and they could actually contest this. MYM may try to set up a death bush bait here.
Charu is definitely trying to set himself a death bush bait in the bottom lane, but this top lane area is around the Baron. It's where Ocelot's not having any of it. He's sticking around, he's got that ball out, keeping vision. He can see that Mackler's not there, so he realizes they're not starting out the Baron, but Charu is on the inhibitor turret right now in that bottom lane. He's continuing to keep the pressure in. The game is racing to get in here, but again, they are going to peel away from the Baron.
So Baron is a very, very risky play for MYM because it's going to take them a long time to burst it down. Varus is their only real consistent damage source. Ryze can help, but they're not the quickest team. SK are grouped up as 5 now against MYM. They've gone in!
They're going aggressive because Charu is not there, simply put. He's taking the inhibitor turret down, though, so they have to get something from this. Will it be anything? They're going to try and get in there, but the Chain of Corruption hits all of them once again. Makata's the only man to go down, but they're going to lose an inhibitor for one person. That's simply not worth it. Meteor Makers, again, tactically outplay them.
SK have not fully committed to this recall, though. 4 of them, they've stuck around, they've stuck on Baron. MYM are now moving into position. There is no Shen for 35 seconds. Teleport is up for Charu, they've called Lipic out. Are they going to get the Baron? Let's see if another fight's going to break out from MYM.
I'm keeping my eye on that teleport. You can see the Baron is almost going to go down. There it is, it's going to be Hercubot that closes it out. Kumon gets caught on, the hook comes out from Lipic, but they're not going to follow it through, but the Nexus turret will go down in a moment. That is going to be Candy Panda picking up the kill, but there is one of the Nexus turrets going down now, and Charu is finally decided to back away. Lipic will go down, but now SK Gaming with a 5-man team with the Baron. Kevin's gone back. They could push a lot of objectives
the
here.
Problem is they are so far back, they have only one outer turret picked up. In order to push, in order to take advantage of these death timers, they have to start all the way at the first turret. You're going to do the best they can to chunk this tower down. Once Candy Panda gets there, it's going to help a lot. And you can see defensive duties of both Hercubot and Kevin. They're holding the fort. They're going to defend against those super minions and a potential Charu X-Pegget.
Yeah, everybody backs away from SK Gaming, so they're going to spend a lot of that money they just earned taking down the Baron. Picking up those kills has definitely closed the gap. You can see it's just 2,500 stacked between the two teams now, so closing half of the gap already just from that little bit of play. But they do have one Nexus turret down. The bottom lane is exposed, and those super minions pushing against them. That's why we see Kevin down in that bottom lane. He's starting to clear that out. He's got himself the Ryla's Crystal Scepter, though, along with that Abyssal Scepter, so definitely got a lot more hit points, a lot of ability power, and a lot of magic penetration as well. So he's going to start doing problems for them. But meanwhile, look at the two mid laners. Three and both closing in on 400 CS.
Yeah, massive, massive numbers. It's just the mechanical skill that these guys have is fantastic. And with the split pushing that Charu is doing, he's actually pulled a little bit further ahead. Look at SK now. They realize they've got this, you know, a power play position where they have the Baron buffer.
Teleport.
And they're going to try and put pressure on the Spotted Tower. Teleports on the bottom. You can see Choru. There's the home guard. He's running in. Look for the charm.
The go for Candy Panda. He's seen a chain of corruption just missing there. Choru's going to try and dive in. It's Candy Panda he wants to get onto. The damage on Ocelot is pretty big. They're going to close in. They're going to get the Shadow Dash across. Ocelot doesn't get the Shockwave off. This could be tragic for SK Gaming. They're going to dive in, but I'm not sure they've got the power to take it. It's going to be Herculebot. He's taken very low. Kevin's getting poked down as well. But Kata may well be the next focus. There goes Candy Panda. He gets caught out. Now it's going to be Nip. Nip will get dropped down as well as the double kill picked up for Choru. Kevin's also getting focused. Well, that is another one down. And just like that, Meet Your Maker's turning back around.
Makata managing to join the party with Stand United. I think he got a four-man Shadow Dash taunt there across the members of SK. And so crucially, Ocelot was popped before the shockwave landed. There are 40 seconds on the clock. This is enough time for Matla, Makata, and Libic to finish this one out. They are tanky. There is only one turret to face check. Are they going to do it? That's the question. They need to get through Herculebot. It is a 1v3 situation. And this is a difficult one to defend.
Surely no problem for them. Makla just working down that Nexus turret. That's going to get dropped down. Herculebot's left on his own. I don't think they're even worried about him. That's going to go straight for that Nexus, and it will be Meet Your Makers picking up their first win in their first match of the
winning team fight.